Hi, I'm Jon Favreau, and this is my career in 4 minutes.
I say we get the menu straight, then we drive back to L.A.
And hit the extra cities on the way?
Why not?
When I wrote Swingers, part of it, I think, was a curiosity. I just received a piece of screenwriting software from my dad. And so I started writing just to see how it worked, and I didn't know that I was writing something that would turn into a movie. There was also a lot of emotional, residual emotion from a relationship that I had not gotten over yet. And then we actually tried to make it, which we did. So it was a bit of a non-standard process. I think the biggest challenge in working on Made was understanding. I had a lot to do creatively with Swingers, and I had thought that my involvement as a co-producer and as a writer and somebody who was interacting with the actors and picking wardrobe and music and in the editing room, I thought this is directing, this is the same thing. But when you don't have somebody else there, because Doug Liman directed Swingers, mm-hmm. not me, I thought it was an easier job than it was. And when all the decisions fall on you, there's a tremendous weight that you feel. So being the guy who has the director's ear and has a tremendous amount of input is a lot different than actually being the guy where the buck stops. On the set, we even stated that our goal was, if we do this right, it's going to be on TV every year. And that was the goal. And it was to make it look like it had been on TV every year. So even the first time it was on TV, it looked like it was on TV for the last 10 years. It was after 9/11. It was like a year later. And I'm from New York. And to show all the landmarks of New York and celebrate it like the films when I grew up was something quite out of the ordinary at that time. You know, everybody was a little on edge still. It was right after all of that. You didn't know what was happening next. And to film in all those New York landmarks like the 59th Street Bridge and the Empire State Building, Lincoln Tunnel, those are very sensitive locations. And so bringing that innocence back to that city was very healing for me and hopefully for New York as well. When we were making the original film, there was, you know, the big thing I wanted to do was make sure I got Robert hired. There was a lot of resistance at the time. But I knew that if I got Robert hired, I could get the tone that I wanted for the film. That the tone could reflect the tone of my smaller movies. Except using the action sequences as a backdrop. And at the time, Marvel, you know, they just formed as a studio. There was, you know, Avi Arad had just left while we were filming. Kevin Feige was just being promoted. And we had a script that was kind of incomplete. So the main challenge of Iron Man was actually just accomplishing and executing the film. We knew we had the pressure if this movie didn't work out well. Marvel would sink as a studio, and they were using their characters as collateral. In the beginning, it all seemed very precarious, and then of course when the film came out and got well reviewed and made the money that it did, that's when the reality sort of set in that we did do something significant. Steven Spielberg, I think, originally was going to direct, then Ron Howard was going to direct with Steven producing. And they had developed this tone of the film of kind of a very sincere take on the Western with the alien story intersecting with that, which I thought was really exciting, something I would have liked to see and work on. And certainly as a director to work with those people as producers was a childhood dream. Working with great actors like Daniel Craig and Harrison Ford was exciting. Unfortunately, it just wasn't received that strongly. People like it. Some people react very well to it, but most people don't see it as the high watermark of my career, which is sad because I really love that film. But I guess, you know, you love all your babies. It's hard for me to scrutinize between them. But I worked tremendously hard on it, and still to this day, as it comes on television, I watch it. I get pulled into it. I think we do both share the appreciation of creative, a little bit of room creatively, having creative freedom. And Carl finds it through his food truck, and I found it through Chef. And after having worked on, you know, the first Iron Man and finding success there, and the success doesn't necessarily lead to greater freedom, it actually leads to a more confining set of circumstances, because now you're shepherding through this brand that has proven itself to be very lucrative for a very big corporation, and they want to protect that investment. And so there's a lot more people with opinions after you have a successful franchise. I thought that it would be, they leave you alone after the first one. But, you know, that's not the way the business works.
Who's hungry?